Yes, it's true! Apple just silently updated their Mac Pro lineup. What? So Apple Silicon Mac Pro is finally here? Well, unfortunately no. Apple updated the Intel Mac Pro. Apple was always slow on desktop updates and put two Mac Pro CPUs, which were on the market for some while already. So despite there were rumors that the new 2022 Apple Mac Pro will be equipped with the brand new Intel Ice Lake Xeon W3300 lineup CPUs, which are right about to come to the market, Apple decided to keep the current Xeon W3200 series CPUs untouched and even sell the Mac Pro for the same price. Big disappointment here. But that means next year we will probably see another Mac Pro upgrade, maybe still Intel one based on the new Xeon 3300 series, and next to it, it may be also the Apple Silicon model. Let's see. But what changed are the GPU upgrades. Apple branded Big Navy in Mac Pro is reality. Here you can see the current GPU options you can buy for your Mac Pro late 2019. W5500X, W5700X, Radeon Pro Vega 2 and Pro Vega 2 Duo cards. But Apple silently a few days ago added new GPU upgrades for Mac Pro, all based on the Big Navy RDNA 2 architecture. So new are Radeon Pro W6800X, Monster Dual GPU Radeon Pro W6800X Duo, and Radeon Pro W6900X. The Radeon Pro W6800X is Apple equivalent of AMD Radeon RX 6800, both with 60 compute units and 3840 stream processors. Apple, as always, did not provide any information about actual GPU core frequency. Apple card is rated for 16 teraflops in single precision versus 16.17 teraflops on AMD reference card and 32 teraflops versus 32.33 teraflops. So almost the same as the reference AMD card. But biggest difference is on the memory size. The reference AMD card maximum memory size is 16 gigabytes of VRAM, but the Apple Radeon Pro W6800X has massive 32 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory. The Radeon Pro W6900X is even bigger beast, with 80 compute units and 5120 stream processors, which is again the same as on the AMD reference card. But here we have slight difference in compute performance, where the Apple card has only 22.2 teraflops in single precision versus 2303 on AMD reference card, and 44.4 teraflops in half precision versus 46.09 teraflops on the AMD reference card. Don't forget, these Apple MPX modules has no fans, it's passively cooled, so for sure are gonna be clocked a little lower. But again, massive difference in memory size, where the Apple Radeon Pro W6900X has doubled the memory of the AMD reference card, so 32 GB of GDDR6 memory. But because I like overkill builds, my favorite card is the Radeon Pro W6800X Duo MPX module. Simply two Radeon Pro W6800X GPUs glued together to a single GPU. Those two GPUs are connected via the hardware Infinity Fabric Link, so the GPUs can communicate with each other directly much faster than it would through the PCI Express slot, specifically at up to 84 gigabytes per second in each direction. So in total, this Radeon Pro W6800X Duo has insane 120 compute units and 7680 stream processors and 64 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory. That's really overkill. That would be enough for me for some while, I hope. And guess what? Of course I ordered one, so I can provide for you some real-life tests in video editing and also 3D viewport performance and 3D rendering. So if you wanna see it, subscribe to my channel and enable all notifications so you won't miss it. I have currently in my 2019 Mac Pro two Radeon Pro Vega 2 cards and one Radeon 7. So I'm a bit limited already now by the amount of PCI Express lanes. So I'm really looking forward to pimp up my Mac Pro even more with the W6800X Duo, and I will keep one Vega Pro 2 card with 32 GB of VRAM just to drive my displays. Yeah, overkill, I know, but why not? Do I need it? No! But I want it. But there is one disappointment in those new GPU specifications. Only HDMI 2.0. The AMD reference cards have HDMI 2.1, so those who wanted to connect some higher resolution, let's say 120Hz display, are out of luck here. But I think for most people, 8 4K displays, 4 5K displays, or 6 6K Pro XDR displays should be quite enough. So, what do you think? Leave me a comment down below if you're gonna buy some of these new GPUs and which one, or if you think it's overpriced crap and waste of money. Or wait for my review of the Radeon Pro W6800X Duo card. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button and the share button below, so it can help to more people and that will in return help to this channel and me to produce for you more interesting videos like this in future. So, thank you for watching, take care, and see you by my new video or live stream. Bye bye, my Macintosh friends.